to Rachna Sansad for successful completion of 15 years and many more to come ahead. I am extremely honored, privileged to be here today to share my work with my gurus, eminent personalities and young architects. I've been asked to complete my presentation in 30 minutes and I'll be very obedient, rather I'll try to complete it before that. This presentation is slightly going to be different because I chose only one of my projects. And after reading the names of the speakers, I was very confident that the broad spectrum of architecture would have been covered by them. And it's been past 1.5 year, we are involved in developing some tall buildings. And I thought it would be very exciting to share that experience with my colleagues and also with the young architects. Well, do you know these people? I think yes, you know them. It includes me and my wife, Alpa. These are very smart people who immediately after graduating from Rachna Sansad joined my firm and are having a very good future with me. And I'm looking forward to see many more faces from our education institute to join our firm and our mission. There's a proverb which says that to hear you have to listen, to be appreciated you have to be quiet, and to be seen you have to grow tall. It's a human instinct and a desire to grow tall and to touch the skies, which can be seen from this ancient temple architecture where even our shrines had a shikharas which were tall in its nature. The churches had a steeples which were tall. Later on, these tall structures were translated into a symbolic expression whereby not many tall structures were built all around the globe to express a thought, like Qutub Minar was built to celebrate the victory. Statue of Liberty was a gift for independence and freedom. Eiffel Tower, engineering excellence, which was built to celebrate 100 years of France, and so on. Somewhere in early 20th century, due to rapid urbanization, especially in the developed countries, where the industrialization translated into urbanization, we saw these two tall buildings, Empire State in New York and Sears Tower in Chicago. And these buildings were not only a symbolic expressions, but they were the building with habitable use into it. And entire world saw that it functions, they are safe, efficient, and it works. Taking an inspiration from there, later on in Southeast Asia, we could see the buildings like Petronas in Kuala Lumpur, Taipei 101 in Taipei. Later on in Dubai, we saw Burj Al Arab and Burj Khalifa, which is probably today's tallest building. This picture shows a various reputed tall buildings which are there all around the globe, right from Burj Khalifa to Empire State. Let us study how it started in India, other in Mumbai. We got the first opportunity to build a tall building for our clients. Clients are Kohinoor and ILNFS, the Infrastructure Leasing Finance Services. The brief was to build a Class A iconic commercial building. You can see from this particular design area matrix, it is a very high density and a very stressful project. You know, we have seen wonderful project of architect Kamal Malik, Roshi and also Sanjay Patil, which are with environmental friendly. We have so many such projects, but I have selected this purposely today to share this tall building experience with you. The plot area is 5 acres, which is 209,000 square foot, which has 3 buildings, 8-story office block, 58-story office tower, which incorporates 1.18 million square foot of office space, 4-story boutique office, and rest of is a parking. Here we had a condition from Mumbai Municipal Corporation to accommodate around 565,000 square foot of a parking, which eventually we have to give it to them. And in view of that, our clients will get FAR. So overall, we are building 2.5 million square foot on a plot of 200,000 square foot. So it's 12 times the plot area, that kind of a density we had on this plot. It was very, very challenging. We had no choice but to go tall. This is a site, all of us are aware of this site. This is near Sena Bhavan, Kohinoor Mill Compound, one of the NTC mill, which was purchased by our clients in auction. Has a wonderful panoramic view of a ocean on the west side. There's a Shivaji Park, Mayor's Bungalow. So nothing is going to come up here. So this site is blessed with a beautiful west side panoramic view. We had to do a lot of study about the temperature. As all of us are aware, Mumbai is predominantly very warm and humid. The humidity structure was also tested. Cloud cover, very heavy rainfalls. We have a stress on our stormwater drain systems. Direct solar radiation, All these climatic conditions were very deeply studied to see its influence on the building and the overall master planning. The wind path was also studied along with the solar path. And then comes most important is the traffic analysis. The site has three accesses. One is from the NC Kelkar Road, which is right in front of Sena Bhavan. One is from the Bhai Padmabhai Road, which leads to Aruparil College and further goes to the Tulsi Point Road. And there's a JK Savant Road, which is on the eastern side of the site, which we have used for the service entrance. There's a northbound traffic, which comes from LG Road, goes to a South Mumbai. And there's a southbound traffic, which goes to the other side of the town. We did the zoning of the entire plot. It has got a very peculiar shape. It becomes very linear and narrow when it moves towards the east side. We had a design brief where we had to develop a retail. This is not a retail like a mall, only a signature upscale shop which a client wanted to develop on our street. Then we separated that retail with an atrium. And this is a white patch which you see is the most preferred footprint from where we'll have a 180 degree panoramic view. So we identified this particular patch of the whole site to place our tower, which is then further separated with the garden, and there is a parking lot which comes behind. There is an extremely high density parking lot which accommodates around 2,000 car parks for the municipal car parking. Then we started crystallizing our ideas, develop a footprint for the tower, which comes over here. The traffic pattern takes us from the Bhai Padmabhai Road and also from the Lady Jamshedji Road. The atrium separates the tower and the building number one. After finalizing the master plan, this is a structure which is going to be in the heart of the city. Client wanted us to develop various options. I know developing an option is not truly an architectural expression that we want to say, but we wanted to come up with some innovative concepts which will make this building very, very iconic and also translate a rich Indian architecture into it. So we developed three schemes. The first scheme was based on a Jantar Mantar sundial, which is at Jodhpur. The second scheme was done on a Sun Temple, which is at Konark, which has got a very beautiful timeless architecture. And third scheme is a very modern expression, diamond, because Kohinoor has resemblance with the diamond. The scheme A, let's see how it goes. The scheme A, sundial, where there was an inspiration from the sundial and marble hemisphere of a Jantar Mantar. The master plan was almost frozen. We had identified the footprint of the tower as well as the retail building and the car parking building. We had to do the orientation of the building based on the various concepts that we're developing. Some sketches were drawn where you can see the curtain wall strategy was developed to resemble and take the inspiration from the Jantar Mantar, where the sundial is having those kind of shapes into its structure. The section, it's a very interesting section. We have developed a lot of sky lobbies for a social sustainability, because that is one of the extremely important factors when you grow tall. These buildings are having a density of 10,000 people in one building. So you can imagine kind of high density structures these are. The building would look like this if we take the inspiration from the Jantar Mantar. Some of the renderings of the lobby, the dusk view, again a closer view of the building, another view. The scheme B was based on Sun Temple, a beautiful Lingaraja temple at Bhuvaneshwar, which has got a very wonderful skin, which is very well articulated with the stone design. We then translated the same particular thing into a layout where the tower position remains same and the retail building comes there. Here you can see the translation of the articulation of the stone skin, which was done on the Konark temple. We developed a microfiber skin, which can be then sandwiched between the laminated glass and can form a curtain wall strategy for the whole building. There's a beacon at the top of the building, which also resembles the shikara, the total apex of the temple. Some of the renderings which expresses the translation of a temple architecture into a tall building. Section again has sky lobbies at various levels. This is how the building would look if you would go with the Sun Temple as an inspiration. Some renderings of the lobby. And scheme C was diamond, master plan. The composition of the building now was very much resembling to the diamond. Building had the facets, the cuts, and the tectonics, which will go ahead with the diamond concept. The elevations were worked out. Again, the curtain wall strategy has a two-level skin, which will then accentuate the shape of the